Yo, remember back on the bully when cats used to harmonize like. Yo, my men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king. Yo, it's about a thing.
Called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck, saying you're a Christian. A Muslim sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your ass cause you're thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gem, baby girl. Respect is just a minimum. But you still defending them now. Lauren is only human. Don't think I haven't been through the same predicament. Let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because of sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again. And his Timbs and his women, him and his men. Come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they defend, popping yang.
Like you got yang.
Let's not pretend. The one to pack pissed out by the waist, man. Crissed out by the casement. Still the name of this basement. The pretty face, man. Claiming that they did a bid, man. Need to take care of their 3 and 4 kids. Been the face in court case when the child support late. Money taking home, breaking. Now you wonder why women hate me. The sleepy silent man. The punk domestic violence man. The quick to shoot the semen. Stop acting like boys and be men. How you gonna win when you ain't right with them? How you gonna win when you ain't right with them? How you gonna win when you ain't right with them? Come again.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back to thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, wake up, all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. We just let it be. Na, 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 na. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it, girl. Just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. But they don't have so very long. Judgment day, so won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders, time to build a...
How you design a those programs, in all of the programs that I attended, all of the education that I had, college, public, and otherwise, nobody ever told me that I was an African woman. Nobody ever told me what the history of African people was. Nobody ever told me that America is business, and without business, you will have nothing and be nothing. And nobody ever told me how to organize business so that I would be able to develop institutions in my own community. So now the sincerity of all of the programs and all of the education has to be questioned, indicted, and convicted, because the bottom line is that America is not and has never tried to produce African adults who are functional, self-sufficient, who understand their politics, their economics, and their relationship to the world politics and the world economics.
America is satisfied with the NAACP, the Urban League, and the traditional we shall overcome civil rights leaders of the 50s and 60s that have been all but abandoned and ignored by younger people, Sister Soulja included.
I think that the dice are loaded, and that's what's left out of Mr. Brown's piece. Mm-hmm. See, there was a period of time in this country after Reconstruction where African people owned a lot of land, owned a lot of businesses, and did a lot of things. But what happened was the American government, the Ku Klux Klan, and other organizations organized in smashing that effort. So it's not that we haven't tried to own land and have not organized businesses. It's that if you are African in America or in Latin America or in the Caribbean or in the continent, you will be hunted no matter what you do, because they do not want us to survive and become self-sufficient. Well, and you can say no, but you haven't lived this life. You haven't lived this life.
We want to be happy. We want to food. I'm talking about that. All right. Okay. Now, to paraphrase Senator Bradley of New Jersey, the state from which your piece was.
Senator Bradley gets much right when he talks.
He does. And he, among other things, and he's not claiming to be particularly original with the observation, we can't get there unless we go together. I have a terrible feeling that behind me are some people who do not agree.
Senator Bradley of the all-white United States Senate said we can't get there unless we all go there together. Sorry, none of us are where he is. That's number one. Number two, you're making a moral appeal to a country that doesn't have a moral conscience. The question becomes that when white people feel serious and angry and upset about abortion, they come out in the thousands up to the millions to say, this is what we believe about abortion. Where is the white outcry against white racism that murders African people all around this entire globe? It doesn't exist. So who are these white good people? I want to meet them. I want to see them.
A few is not enough. But that's might be all we can get.
And guess what? I don't work with all I can get. What I work with is what I have. Listen, you have to have some confidence in the power of African people amongst ourselves to establish a foundation. We have utter chaos in our city, and you got to do that. You can have a program. We built a lot of institutions, and those institutions have not been effective. The majority of millions of African youth in this country are dying mentally, dying spiritually, dying emotionally, dying academically. And you may have a program, Mr. Brown may have a program, but what we got to talk about is an American government that traps millions of African people. Don't go to your program. Don't go to Brown's program. Millions of African people, not only here, but all around the world. And if we are not honest enough to say who are our friends, who are our enemies, to know what friend is, to know what an enemy is, we will constantly be trying to get into people's parties, to shake our butts with them, to get them to like us. And that's not the question. The question is, what can we do in next ourselves to secure ourselves from our enemies so that we will be able to divide and
You're a black man. you wait and sit in the
pit.
People out there with triggers ready to pull it while you trying to jump in front of the